And now, the continuing adventures of a little girl surrounded by monsters. Yeah, you open that up. So, we put down the small cannon. We load it up with pepper. Then, we need to lure someone through that door. With this, perhaps? Let's give it a try. Try. Again, timing is the key. Why would you have a tiny cannon like that, which is still loaded with gunpowder and fully operational? That seems odd. You start moving, I shall begin the process of firing the cannon. Like now. And he sneezes himself to death. Oh, apparently he sneezed the meat, flesh off his bones. Somehow. Slightly out of the way. Okay, it looks like I should put something in its hand. Didn't work. Anything here? Aha! So we are not supposed to use on the statue. Well, let's take a look out into the hallway. There's the little cook. I killed once. I guess they all are pulled back here into the sheep. No. Well, I guess they are all probably undead immortals. So I think you can use. Summon the dump waiter using the bell. And so, what good is this? And what the heck do I need a chicken food for? Okay. This gets you. How did they build the shaft between the boat and the house anyway? Supposed to find here.
pay you.
Well. Okay, I have a chicken foot. Why? Oh, maybe you only get past these once you have. I mean, once you are going through here again as can be. So. Oh dear. Right. Was I supposed to bring the captain's stuff back to Canby? I seem to recall him saying that. Well, let's see if we can go get back to him. This looks like an opening. Yeah, can you climb down it from some direction? No? To your floaty umbrella thing. I suppose I can't get past you. Or is that what the chicken foot is for? Hi. And yeah. Yes, I have to go here. But then what? How? Okay, a random key. What do I use that for? Okay. So why was the key just lying in front of the cabinet? Hello. I remember this part. Can use both the molasses and the ice box to get rid of some enemies.
Hey, you.
For you see. Let's put them, for instance, here. But no! We're supposed to get stuck into molasses. Get it? Slow as molasses? Or maybe I used the wrong command, which caused her to just drop the actual pot and not dump the contents on the floor. Also, who is operating that dump waiter? There's nobody on this end to hear the bell. someone on the boat. There we go. Try dumping these things at the doorway. Hey, to... Okay. Ah, there we go. I think he actually will try to avoid the molasses. Yeah, he gets stuck and... Wait for it. Yeah, he's not getting out of that. I guess the molasses are the same color as these brown floor tiles. We call that orange, reddish brown, light reddish brown. Well, let's just leave him be. Okay, I think I want to head upstairs. Anyway, what I was waiting for is that eventually that guy, well, apparently perishes stuck into molasses. Seems.
Hey, you.
Where is the icebox? It does much the same, except instead of getting stuck, they slip over on it. So, I see something that wasn't here before. So... Am I supposed to go down and use this on the pipe organ? Sure, why not? Also, you can use those same traps to get rid of several enemies. Just need to lure them over to the same bit. Hello, mister. Still stuck? No. Okay. So there's a force field surrounding the organ. Seems somewhat bizarre. So nothing here. I guess so. How do you know the force field is evil? Don't be so judgmental. We have to wonder if that's a glitch and the force field is supposed to actually be somewhere else. Let's go back. Why is the token in the pool table anyway? Okay, so let's try this. Going into the hidden back office or something here. Oh, right. That. Yeah, the witch told about things and somehow we saw actually where the captain's secret compartment or something was. Oh! Hello?
I overcame voodoo, an unpublished chapter of manuscript found in a bottle.
You know, voodoo and this... actual voodoo is a religion which is pretty much half Catholicism and this whole undead stuff is really more of a folk magic thing.
In the heart of the storm, the Malay suddenly emerged from the cabin, waving a chicken leg. The possessed one would have given his soul for chalk. Captain Pregg's orders rang out about the howling of the tempest. Do as he says. A monstrous wave had taken Giovanno, the cabin boy. Another terrifying wall of water loomed to starboard, demanding its due. The Malay grabbed the chalk as if it were a diamond-studded crown. Upon the deck, he drew a strange pattern. Papa Legba! Screamed the demented savage, waving his chicken leg. The effect was prodigious. The waves stopped where it was, twixt heaven and hell. He then searched inside the leather pouch that he had hanging round his neck and took out a piece of mirror. He placed it in the center of the altar that stood beneath the mizzenmast and on which he had drawn a V. Drawing from his red belt the strange staff which he always carried, the Malay shook it at the wave and chanted. The giant wave sank gently into the ocean. Voodoo! Voodoo! Yelled our savior as Giovanno's body struck the vessel's hull. I can bring him back. The Malay looked over at Prext, who answered, no, the fool could not even read.
Hey, Pregst, that's the first name of the that tree villain in the first game when he was. I forgot the first name. Ezekiel, some maybe, no, but something like that. He's Pregst, and then he was Elijah Underwood, was it? So, that's a nice connection. So now we know at least something about what to do with the chicken foot, chicken leg. So, does it work just as well if you have that, you know, foot of the chicken which is not really used for any kind of food, or if you have a chicken, the kind of chicken leg that doesn't have the foot and is more of a food thing. Yeah, claws. Ooh. Now I got me a staff. And I looks like the molasses are gone now. So what do I do with the staff? Maybe this will dispel the evil force field. No? Ah, the force field is still there. But hey, I do have the staff, so hooray for that. Do I now go back down? Oh dear. Yeah, no more molasses. The first time I played, I actually did not use ice on the guy upstairs and instead saved it up for this, and I believe this is also what I was thinking of when I was talking about somehow being able to lure a guy right about here, and then this fold out bed would come and smack him on the head. I still have a sandwich. What do I do with that? Well, seems like it's time for me to again try to figure out what to do, maybe read a walkthrough a bit, and then we'll be back.